Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by Makerdemi. This is Aditi and I am a part of the instructor team at Makerdemi. In this video, we will be having an overall look at all the storage and database services provided by Azure. Why would anyone want to store data on the cloud? The main advantage of letting a cloud provider store and manage your data is that you'll always get the option to automatic backup and recovery. To make your data available to users around the world, you can replicate your data in different data centers across the world. And to check out the data consumption and other metrics, cloud providers often provide support for data analytics. Anytime you store your data, it is encrypted to make sure it is highly secure. You will also have control to manage who has access to that data. The best part about the storage service is, for every type of data, there is a dedicated service available. We will see them shortly. There are also storage tiers to prioritize your data based on the amount of usage. Typically, Azure Storage can hold three types of data: structured, semi-structured, and unstructured data. In short, structured data looks like this. Semi-structured will look like this. And unstructured will look like this. If you want to store structured data, you probably would want to use SQL. And yes, Azure's SQL database will satisfy your needs. You don't have to manage the storage infrastructure. Azure will take care of security, scaling, and all those nitty-gritty stuff you would want while maintaining a database. If you have an already running SQL database locally, you can migrate it to the cloud using the Azure Database Migration Service. There is also a service for MariaDB users. The other globally distributed database service is CosmosDB. It is a NoSQL database. Because it is globally distributed, it is highly available to users around the globe. You will also be able to scale this. You can also easily migrate to other open source databases using their APIs from CosmosDB. CosmosDB can handle mission critical workloads, and do you know, it has enterprise grade security by default. So, what else would you need? The next is blob storage. This is useful for storing any form of unstructured data like files, images to gigabytes of binary data or video files. Using blob storage, you will be able to manually stream large video audio files directly to the user. Blob storage is highly scalable. Also, it is used to store data for backup, disaster recovery, etc. The next one is file storage. From the name you can guess, you'll be able to store files and do secured file sharing operations using this service. The file sharing protocol used here is the industry standard server message block protocol, which encrypts the data while being transited and also when they are stored. This service is mostly used for sharing files around the world or application data sharing. Any number of services can access the file storage share simultaneously. Cool, right? Now, let's see about data lake storage. This one stores both structured and unstructured data. Another unique type of storage is queue storage. This is used to store messages from applications securely. To understand this, think of it as something similar to MQTT publish subscribe messages. This service provides synchronous message queuing for communication between applications or services. And those are the storage and database services provided by Azure. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.